Yeah, so, yeah. Do you remember my nice sunny day yesterday at Nicky's? Well, this is today. It is absolutely bucketing down. I'm so wet and miserable now. But at least I got one nice day. Guys, look. Just look at it. Just enjoy the moment. This is what Nicky made for dinner. Sunday roast. There's Nicky. Say hi, Nicky. Poor Nicky's tired. She's been up all night baking and cooking this dinner all day. Look. This is appreciation post right here. It's going to get demolished in 3, 2, 1. Check it out. Look here. It's a double.
Love has flown all alone. I sit, I wonder why, oh why you left me, oh Sandy. Why, oh Sandy.
It's time to go home. Waiting for my taxi. Gonna miss this one and our singing. But big thanks to Nicky and Craig for letting me stay. It's been so much fun. Have you had a good time?
Yeah.
Been fun?
Yeah.
I'm just about to go home. My hair's still a riot.
Yeah.
You tired?
Yes.
Shouldn't be tired. Slept until 11:30. Mind you didn't go to sleep until like 2 o'clock in the morning. And I didn't go to sleep till about 2 in the morning because I was watching Family of Hope vlogs, they're live, that
watching,
I missed.
And I was watching Dan Hill.
And by the way, oh, I didn't tell you, see on Family Hope vlogs, the live feed that I missed. Do you know how many people gave them super chats? So dark. Oh, I'm so tired. We finally got home at about 1 o'clock in the morning, I think, just after 1 o'clock in the morning. We actually left Nicky's at 2 o'clock yesterday afternoon. So it took us about 11 and a half hours to travel from Wolverhampton to Birmingham, Birmingham to Manchester, Manchester to Preston, Preston to Lancaster, Lancaster to Glasgow. And then we got off at Glasgow and we had to get a bus from Glasgow to East Kilbride. So yes, by the time we got home, it was very late. I was absolutely tired. It is now Tuesday, 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so actually 24 hours since I left Nicky's. I had the best time. We had such a laugh. It was seriously good, really, really good. You remember I was telling you about my ceiling? Check this out. Yes, that's right. I have water pouring out of my electrics.
How is that possible?
Like, really though? Absolute joke. Phoning them right now.
Is this not ridiculous? Look at this! Look! Look! I'm so angry! I apologise for the shouting, but this is absolutely ridiculous, Ken! Look! Phone the MP, they said. We'll fix it, they said. Yeah, that's why I've got water dripping out my lights. Oh, and wait, check this out. Oh, there's some more dripping. Woohoo, I love my house. 2 years. 2 years and it's still happening. Yes, let's just have water pouring out our electrics because that's a whole lot of I've got water coming down my wall. I've got water coming out my ceiling.
Okay,
I've got water coming out my light switch. Dude, this is so not okay. And then we've actually got it coming along to Stuart's door. I've actually got it coming down the wall. I've got it coming out the lights. Wonderful. I love it. No, but really. Hi, Abby.
Yeah. It's been an ongoing problem for 2 years, but this has just happened today, and I'm really getting annoyed with people coming out, looking at it, agreeing with me, and then walking out the door again.
Right.
I've had a joiner up already that looked at it and said there's nothing they could do. I've had the electrician, because this is leaking as well. He said he can't do anything until the plumber came, and apparently nobody from the council is allowed on the roof, even though they've got scaffolding up, I think that's just for show. So...
Why are you not on the roof?
Oh, I don't know.
Do they not go up on the roof?
I don't know, I get told...
No, did the joiner have to go up on the roof?
No, he said it wasn't allowed to, it wasn't worth his job because the people taking pictures of them and stuff. Even though the scaffolding is sitting right there, there's a latch right there, but nobody at all...
I've got that actually. I've got a good step for the moment.
Okay, thanks. I've already filled this bucket. And can we all be able to stop this tonight?
Can you pay on the phone on the weekend?
Good to see that somebody has allowed up on the roof. I did ask if he was going to get the problem fixed today, and his answer was hopefully.
So the plumber's finally here, he's up on the roof in the water tank. I can hear him banging and stuff. It's clearly not stopped yet. We'll see if we can fix it.
judge me by the look in the organ grinder. He'll judge me by the fact that my face don't fit.
It's tightened that the monkeys is on my shoulder. He's waiting for the day when he gets me.
But I don't need no alibi. I'm a puppet on a string. I just need this stage to be seen.
We all need a pyramid to remind us what is real. Hold my eye and know what it means. Cause I'm out of my mind. I'm out of my mind. Out of my mind.
I'm out of my mind. I'm out of my mind.
I'm out of my mind.
I'm out of my mind. I'm out of my mind.
Judging by the look on the organ grinder, you're judging by the fact that my face don't fit.
It's judging that the monkey sits on my shoulder. He's waiting for the day when he gets me.
What's the script?
Tank top.
Right.
Tank the hole as well. So, there's a drain on the tank top. You can only drain the tank. You can only drain. But, in the tank room, because it's been half the bridge, the whole floor is a bit out of water.
And that's what just going to come in here?
Mm.
Awesome. So, with that drain in the tank?
She's going to keep doing that, unfortunately.
We'd have to be careful to get moved out of here because this is absolutely
ridiculous. I don't know, I'm going to
need to go to control from in there. Right, can you phone them and tell them that I'm not happy, I want moved out of this flat, it's been gone for 2 years and I'm sick of it. I'm honestly, I know it's not your personal fault, but I'm so sick of this right now. I've got black mould all over my walls. I don't want to be here anymore. No electricity or nothing.
Just emptied tub number one, tub number two, there's tub number three.
It's now leaking downstairs. I can't.
So get this, the plumber says that he wasn't called for the job until 4:45. I phoned them at 3 o'clock. So it took them nearly 2 hours just to tell the plumber that I had a water problem. I'm going further, I'm telling you, I'm sending letters to the MP, I'm emailing them right now, and I'm also going to the news, and then I'm going down to the council tomorrow and I'm going to raise holy hell because this is ridiculous. Seriously, 3 hours, 3.5 hours now, it's still pouring and nobody's actually done anything to fix it, apart from look at it and agree. So after all that, the kids are away to Big Stuart, Stuart's dad's, because I weren't having them staying in the house overnight when it's cold and wet and dark and no electricity. So that'll just be me that's staying here tonight like that. The water has slowed down to just a few drips. They said that that's pretty much, you know, the most of the water that's came through. So that was that. And the passing words from them, parting words from them, was somebody will be in touch to assess the damage. And then they left. And that's it. That's it. I've sent a letter, email, including video footage, all of this, to my local MP, Lisa Cameron. I'm also going to put an official complaint to the council because they didn't actually contact the plumber until 4:45, even though I asked for them at 2:45. So they left me 2 hours with dripping water and no call out for a plumber. But they did send a joiner and an electrician because, like, they can fix water pipes. So angry. But anyways, yeah, it's done. I'm sorry this wasn't the most fun vlog, but I really did want to capture the amount of crap that I need to put up within this flat. It's absolutely ridiculous. Anyways,
I'll see you next time.